Welcome. I am Craig Russell C. Saed.
I'm Lovely Nario.
Princess Kate.
And we are your presenters for today.
We're going to present the paper titled A Review of Maximum Power Point Tracking Algorithms for Wind Energy Systems by Abdullah M.A., Yatim A.H.M., Tan C.W., and Saidur R. Wind energy systems have gained tremendous attention over the past decade as one of the most promising renewable energy sources due to the probable depletion, high cost, and negative environmental impacts of the conventional energy sources. Wind energy is inexhaustible and pollution-free source. Therefore, a wind energy generation system could be one of the potential sources of alternative energy in the future. This study was conducted in Malaysia, where numerous research studies have also been conducted in the area of renewable energy, which include economic feasibility studies in renewable energy utilization, such as PV diesel system and PV wind diesel system. What's in the slide right now is the ideal power curve of a wind turbine. Wind turbines are controlled to operate only in a specified range of wind speeds, bounded by the cut-in and cut-out speeds. Beyond these limits, the turbine should be stopped to protect both the generator and the turbine. In the figure, it can be observed that there are three different operational regions. The first is the low-speed region, where the turbine should be stopped and disconnected from the grid to prevent it from being driven by the generator. The second is the moderate speed region that is bounded by the cut-in speed at which the turbine starts working and the rated speed at which the turbine produces its rated power. The turbine produces maximum power in this region as it is controlled to extract the available power from the wind. In the high-speed region, the turbine power is limited so that the turbine and generator are not overloaded and dynamic loads do not result in mechanical failure. It is noteworthy that to protect the turbine from structural overload, it should be shut down above the cutout speed. This paper focuses on the moderate speed region where the maximum power point tracking algorithm is needed. In the slide is the schematic diagram of the reviewed wind turbine. The system supplies a resistive load and consists of a wind turbine rotor, the PMSG or the permanent magnet synchronous generator, the rectifier, and the boost converter. Basically, wind turbine converts the wind energy into mechanical energy, which then runs a generator to create electrical energy. The mechanical power generated by a wind turbine can be expressed as the mechanical power of the wind turbine in kilowatts, the air density in kilogram per cubic meter, the turbine radius in meter, the velocity of the wind in meter over seconds, the power coefficient, which can be expressed by the tip speed ratio and the blade pitch angle. In this slide is the maximum power point tracking techniques. The first one is the tip speed ratio control. Tip speed ratio refers to the ratio between the wind speed and the speed of the tips of the wind turbine blades. We should note that the further away from the center, the faster the blades spin. If the rotor of the wind turbine spins too slowly, most of the wind will pass straight through the gap between the blades, therefore giving it no power. But if the rotor spins too fast, the blades will blur and act like a solid wall to the wind. Also, rotor blades create turbulence as they spin through the air. If the next blade arrives too quickly, it will hit that turbulent air. So sometimes, it is actually better to slow down the blades. In tip speed ratio control, the optimal tip speed ratio for a given wind turbine is constant regardless of wind speed. If TSR remains constantly at the optimal value, it is guaranteed that the extracted energy will be maximized. Therefore, this method seeks to force the energy conversion system to remain at the optimal point. So what happens is that The wind speed is always measured and is compared to the reference tip speed ratio. Then the difference is fed to the controller. Then the controller tells the generator to change its speed to reduce the error. Although this method seems simple as wind speed is directly and continuously measured, a precise measurement of wind speed is impossible in reality and increases the cost of the system.
The optimum torque or OT control was the next MPPT technique used. It can be observed from the black diagram that the principle of this method is to adjust the permanent magnet synchronous generator or the PMSG torque according sa maximum power reference torque ng wind turbine at a given wind speed. So this method is simple, fast, and efficient. However, the efficiency is lower compared to TSR control method because it does not measure the wind directly, meaning the wind changes are not reflected instantaneously and significantly on the reference signal. Next is the power signal feedback or PSF control method. So the reference optimum power curve ng wind turbine should be obtained first from the experimental results, unlike in OT control method. So this is the black diagram of the PSF control. So yung data points ng maximum power output at ng corresponding speed ng wind turbine ay naka-record sa lookup tape. So there is no difference between PSF and the previous method, which is the OT control, with regards sa performance at complexity of implementation. Last is the perturbation and observation or P&O control, also known as the hill climb searching or HCS method. So ginagamit ito mostly sa wind systems kasi dinedetermine ito yung maximum operating point para ma-maximize yung energy being extracted. So the diagram shows the HCS control, the larger and smaller perturbation. So this method is based on perturbing a control variable in small step size and by observing the resulting changes in the target function until the slopes become zero. This method is flexible and independent since this method does not require prior knowledge of the wind turbine's characteristic curve. So, but there are still other methods to measure wind speeds, the fuzzy logic control method and the hybrid method. So yung fuzzy logic control method has the advantages of fast convergence, parameter insensitivity, and acceptance of noisy and inaccurate signals. Yung hybrid method naman ay combination ng two methods na nag-exploit ng advantages ng isang technique para ma-overcome yung disadvantage ng isa. So in the next slide, are the formulas previously used in the described MPPT techniques. So the formulas are to find the wind speed, optimum power torque, turbine mechanical power, TSR, OT, and P&O. So since the study used these formulas, they used computational techniques and the numerical analysis of data, each method is a quantitative.
For the review results and discussion, the following diagram were shown after performing the three MPPT control method. As presented, Figure 12 shows the system parameter where the load resistances was considered to be 20 for all simulations, while the step sizes in P and O of the duty cycle and the input voltage were fixed at 0.5 times 10 raised to negative 3 and 0.001 voltage respectively. Figure 13 shows the wind changes. Figure 14 shows the obtained performance from the different methods. Figure 15 depicts the generator's output power for each method. and as shown in the picture. While the first two methods were stabilized similarly in 0.025 seconds, 0.175 seconds more is needed for the third one. By taking the maximum mechanical input energy of the generator as a reference and measuring the electrical energy output of the generator under the selected method, the efficiency could then be calculated. Within these diagrams, a summarized tabulated result was presented in table. Based on results and analysis, the OTC controller was found to be the fastest in achieving the steady state. The recovery time upon wind speed change was also faster for this algorithm. Additionally, the OTC method reached the highest value of coefficient power and maintained that value even after the change in wind speed. It was followed by the P&O input voltage method, which took almost twice the time needed to reach the steady state, with the average value of coefficient power being 0.4607. While the P&O duty cycle method was found to be the slowest and least efficient method, as the response time was 8 times longer than the first method. It was also found that P&O duty cycle method did not maintain the same value of maximum coefficient power all the time, as it decreased from 0.46 to 0.42 when a step change in the wind speed occurred. Since the conventional perturbation and observation method were used with a fixed step size, the ripples of the coefficient power changed under the wind speed variation. As there is some difficulty with choosing the appropriate MPPT algorithm for a given wind system, a different table was presented to show the considerable aspect in selecting a particular MPPT strategy. In this part, since the method used in gathering the data are in a quantitative method, it is efficient to use appropriate figures, particularly table, for summarizing the result as it easily compared the data. In conclusion, this paper reviewed and discussed the available MPPT algorithms for wind energy systems. The authors analyzed a simulation and comparison of three selected control methods in terms of efficiency and speed of response. Simulation results demonstrated the superiority of the OTC methods in terms of simplicity and accuracy. This method obtained the maximum average value of coefficient power and maintained it at its maximum even with changes in wind speed. Nevertheless, its dependency on wind turbine characteristic made it inflexible. On the other hand, the P&O method is flexible and simple in implementation, but is less efficient and can be problematic in determining the optimum step size. Compared to the perturbation of the duty cycle, perturbation of the input voltage was found to be better in terms of accuracy and response time. Determining the adaptive step size algorithm and combining two or more of the available methods will improve the performance and overcome some of the obstacles found in the current method.